In this video, I'll identify the element that has the following electron configuration, and then I'll go on to discuss some of the basics of writing electron configurations for different elements. Here we have 1s2, 2s2, 2p4, and all we're really looking for to identify the element is simply these superscripts. They look like exponents, but what they give us is the number of electrons. They're not exponents, it's the number of electrons in each subshell. So we have 2 electrons in the 1s subshell, and 2 electrons in the 2s subshell, and 4 electrons in the 2p subshell. So 2 plus 2 plus 4 is 8. We have 8 electrons, and the matching element that has 8 electrons is oxygen. And the way you find that is by looking at the atomic number in the periodic table. And the atomic number exactly matches the number of electrons in the element. So oxygen is the answer. Now, to expand on that a little bit, you might see this also written as 1s2 with a little space, and then 2s2, and then 2p4. Now, what I'm doing here is leaving some room for a box on each of these, and I'm going to put 3 boxes above the 2p subshell. And I'll tell you why in just a second. First, the 1s2. Well, you can only have 2 electrons in the 1s subshell. So one has to have a spin of up, and one has a spin of down. And that's according to something called the Pauli principle. And what that says is that 2 electrons cannot have the exact same quantum numbers. So what that means is that they've got the quantum number, the principal quantum number of 1, and then they're in the subshell of S. And so L equals 0, that's the angular momentum quantum number. But regardless, what we're looking at here is the spin, right? So one spin is up, or positive, and one is down, or negative. So same thing with 2s. You can only have 2 electrons in that subshell, so one is up and one is down. Now I'm going to switch colors here. The 2p subshell, well, this p shell has 3 possible orbitals, and that's why I have three boxes here. 3 subshells. Well, if you have 3 subshells, then in each of those, or 3 orbitals, in each of those orbitals, you could have 2 electrons. But I only have 4 total, so how should I arrange those 4 electrons here? Should I put 1 up and 1 down, and then 1 up and 1 down? I could do that and be done with it, with those 4. But there's something called the Hund's rule, H-U-N-D, and that says that we want as many electrons in parallel as we can in each subshell. That's the easiest way of explaining it. So I'm going to fill this up with up right away. Now I can put the down, the remaining, because I need a 4th electron, anywhere here. So typical convention says I'll just put it in the first box, but I could have put it in the second or the third, because the energy level is not different on any of these different orbitals, whereas the S subshell has a slightly lower excited state, you could say, of the electron than the P subshell. Okay, so you might see that as well to further explain what's going on with the electrons. Now, I want to talk just a little bit more about writing the electrons before I finish this video. And just to show you, this oxygen, how we wrote it like this. Well, if you wrote the helium, the electron configuration for helium, that would just be 1s2. So a shorthand way of writing oxygen, and a very common way of writing that, would be the helium core. So that's HE in these brackets, and then what is added to that. So it's like saying whatever helium was, this is what this helium core is like saying, whatever helium was plus whatever you have to add for oxygen. So we've got the 1s2 for helium, and then the 2s2, and then the 2p4. So you see how that matches what we have for oxygen. Now if we move on down that row in the periodic table and you get to neon, neon would equal the helium core, and then plus whatever is added to it. So 2s2, 2p6 is what would be there. And then you go to the next row and you have sodium. Well, then sodium is going to start in with using the neon core. So it's going to say everything that we have for neon plus something else, plus an electron in the 3s subshell. So that's the way this goes. And then you go on and on and on. You can even get to uranium. Uranium is the radon core plus 7s to 5f3. 6d1, for example, and radon has 86 electrons plus another, and then for uranium you have another 2 plus another 3 plus another 1 for a total of 5 plus 86, or an atomic number of 6 plus 86 for an atomic number of 92. Uranium has 92 electrons. So you see how it follows that pattern using the core. And then you continue on to the next row and you use the previous core element. I hope that was helpful. If you did find this video helpful, well then consider liking it or sharing it with a friend.